Let us suppose the mind to be, as we say, white paper, void of all characters, without any ideas. How does it come to be furnished?
To this
I answer in one word, from experience.
Like the experience of letters and digits, the experience of colors too is one of the richest experiences of humankind. Color is encoded in our DNA. If about 20 pieces of colored glass taken inside a kaleidoscope are made to form about 10 new patterns per minute, it will take us about 50,000 crores of years to view all the patterns that the kaleidoscope can produce.
Colors speak all languages. They are the smiles of nature and the laughs and sighs of life.
It is from nature that we get our first impression of color. Nature, with its flowers, trees, skies, etc., offers color schemes where the color is already created and it remains for us only to enjoy and appreciate.
Lord of the far horizons, give us the eyes to see over the verge of sundown the beauty that is to be.
Jharu 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 jhare ranger jharna ay 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 asher asher shudhay hriday bharna jharu 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 jhare ranger jharna
it pours and pours and pours and pours a cascade of colors come oh come fill your heart with its glowing charms it pours and pours and pours and pours a cascade of
jharu 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 jhare ranger jharna ay 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 asher asher shudhay hriday bharna jharu 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 jhare ranger jharna
it pours and pours and pours and pours a cascade of colors come oh come fill your heart with its glowing charms it pours and pours and pours and pours a cascade of
বন্যা ধারায় ধারায় চিত্ত মৃত্যু আবেশ ধারায় ও সেই রসের পরশ বেধরা নিত নবীন বর্ণা ঝরো 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 ঝরে রঙের ঝর্ণা
It pours and pours and pours and pours a cascade of colors.
সেই মুক্ত বন্যা ধারায় ধারায় চিত্ত মৃত্যু আবেশ ধারায় ও সেই রসের পরশ বেধরা নিত নবীন বর্ণা ঝরো 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 ঝরে রঙের ঝর্ণা
It pours and pours and pours and pours a cascade of colors.
Jharo 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 jhare ranger jharna.
It pours and pours and pours and pours a cascade of colors.
Jharo jhar 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 jhare ranger jharna
It pours and pours and pours and pours a cascade of color
Color has an all-pervasive presence in history, anthropology, archaeology, religion, myth, mysticism, art, architecture, literature, culture, rituals, symbolism, astrology, astronomy, medicine, science, alchemy, and everything under the sun.
Newton, with his prism and silent face, the marble index of a mind forever, voyaging through strange seas of thought alone.
The study of the science of color began in Greece. Aristotle discovered that color is a factor of light. Materials around us look colorful due to absorption of light by the materials themselves. Seneca considered dispersion as a phenomenon due to the property of the prism. It was Newton who gave the first scientific explanations for colors. The science of color draws on three scientific disciplines: physics, psychophysics, and psychology. Psychology perceives color as a visual impression on our minds. Psychophysics views color as a response of the retina to a physical stimulant, and physics treats color as a radiant energy, light being causative of the properties of color. Color has three attributes: hue, saturation, and brightness, which are determined respectively by the dominant wavelength, purity, and luminance of light. Maxwell discovered that of all colors of light, red, green, and blue are the primary colors. These three combining together or with one another are responsible for the production of all other colors, including white. His trichromatic theory contributed immensely to the development of color photography and cinema. The primary colors of light are red, green, and blue. The original chemical colors are red, yellow, and blue. Taking both systems together, the primary colors are red, blue, green, and yellow. The primary colors, mixing with one another, produce a great variety of other colors. A mixture of colors in the case of colors of light is additive, but subtractive in the case of chemical colors. But generally, the colors we see around us are products of both additive and subtractive processes, working simultaneously on our eyes and the brain. And light is all colors. Colors due to absorption, reflection, refraction, dispersion, interference, polarization, polar light, incandescence, fluorescence, electrical energy, surface tension, camouflage, green flash above the horizon, reduction of air light, auroral bands, caustic network, high altitude irisation, and the Newton color disc denoting the vibgyor. The science of color helps mankind to understand the nature of colors, bring it under its control, and make technical, medical, and scientific use of it.
The first of all simple colors is white, although some would not admit that black or white are colors, the first being a source or receiver of colors, and the latter totally deprived of them.
Aristotelian theory deduced that all colors could be made by adding black or white to yellow, red, purple, green, or blue. Primitive man used colors as symbols. Only black, red, white, and blue were in use. Till the medieval period, the use of colors was connected with mysticism and occultism. Color played an important role in all cultures. In Hindu traditions, Krishna is dark blue, Radha white, Shiva white, Kali black, endowing color symbolism with a religious quality. In Christian art, the Father is white, the Son blue, the Holy Spirit red, sanctity yellow, and death black. In Buddhist myth, heaven is yellow, Lord Buddha golden yellow, and the Maitreya Buddha blue. Dreaming in color, thought is blue that refers to the sky, emotion is red that refers to blood, reality is green that refers to nature, intuition is yellow that refers to the sunlight. Just as symbols have characteristic colors, so colors too have symbolic images.
I am the light of the world. He who follows me shall not walk in darkness, but have the light of life. There is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Allah nuru samawati wal ard, masalu nurihi kamishkatin fiha misbah, al misbahu fi zujaja.
Allah is the light of the cosmos and the earth. His light can be compared to a shelf that holds a lamp, placed within a glass container that glows like a resplendent star.
Diva tapati adicho ratting abhati chandima.
The sun glows in the day, the moon in the night. The warrior glows in his armor, the Brahmin in his meditation. But the Buddha glows day and night, illuminated by his native energy.
Rushadvatsa rushati shvetagat.
There bursts the luminous light of lights, setting all aglow. What a resplendent presence, tearing the darkness asunder.
The tide of colors, the storm of colors.
A fest of colors, colors all to colors, colors all.
A fest of colors, colors all to colors, colors all.
A fest of colors, colors all to colors, colors all.
A fest of colors, colors all to colors, colors all.
The time of colors, the mood of colors, the dream of colors, colors dream.
A fest of colors, colors all to colors, colors all. A fest of colors, colors all to colors, colors all.
A flood of colors, colors all to colors, colors all.
A flood of colors, colors all to colors, colors
all to colors, colors all, colors all, colors
all to colors, colors all, colors all, colors
all to colors, colors all, colors, colors all to colors, colors all, colors, colors all to colors, colors all colors, colors all.
Color is a go-between between two other colors. One color is always dependent on another. Leonardo da Vinci was the pioneer in introducing color discrimination and color scheme in painting. Movements in the arts in different periods have demonstrated differences and distinctions in the use of colors, as in prehistoric, Neolithic, ancient, Bronze Age, Greek art, art of the city-states, the Hellenistic world, Etruscan age, Roman art, early Christian, Byzantine, medieval, pre-Romanesque, Romanesque, Gothic, International Gothic and Late Gothic, Early Renaissance, High Renaissance, Late Renaissance, Early Baroque, High Baroque and Classicism, Late Baroque, Rococo, Neoclassicism, Romanticism and Ideal Landscapism, Realism, Impressionism, Post-Impressionism and Art Nouveau, Symbolism, Fauvism, Purism and Pointillism, Cubism and Futurism, Dadaism, Art Deco and Suprematism, Expressionism, Neoplasticism, Surrealism, Abstract Expressionism, Post-Painterly Abstraction and Automatism, Pop Art, Op Art and Photorealism, Neo-Expressionism and Minimalism, and New Directions. Nature's illumination and reflectivity is conveyed by artists through color's reflectivity alone. If the light is sufficient and viewing conditions ideal, we can identify almost 10,000 different color variations. But a palette of 100 will suffice for an artist. There were 16 colors in use during the Renaissance. In the modern period, the number rose to 32. Specialists in the field have identified primarily 92 colors in the postmodern era. There are several uses of color in paintings for representation or reflection or symbolism or expression of sentiments. But the artist does not always use visible colors. A sense of colors deeply embedded in his consciousness could very well be the source of his coloration. For example, Picasso the Faun versus Kandinsky the Monk. An artist's use of color needs to be studied in terms of the subjectivity implicit in what may be described as the color of the mind, the color of sensitivity, the color of consciousness. The latest addition to the world of color is fractal art. The fractal universe deals with special types of irregularity. The intriguing and beautiful world of fractals blends art and science to create a myriad of colors, forms, and patterns which bring us a new mind-expanding experience. Color is intimately related to sculpture.
With chiseled touch, the stone unhewn and cold becomes a living mold. The more the marble wastes, the more the statue grows.
Id in the grid, soul in the plinth, the architect God.
Color is intimately related to architecture.
Sounds clothe themselves in color, and colors contain music.
Poets, scientists, and musicians have noticed a clear connection between color and sound. Newton thought of the spectrum as a kind of octave. Kandinsky was the first to suggest that color has music. He wrote what he called a color drama, The Yellow Sound. Goethe had a theory of color and music. Color is intimately related to dance.
Dancing is the loftiest the most moving, the most beautiful of the arts, because it is no mere translation or abstraction from life. It is life itself.
Carl von Eckartshausen had his theory of visible music.
Words, sadly, she wandered, loveliest of maidens in flowery meadows.
Music, the notes of a flute, plaintive, gay, rising tones.
Color, olive, mixed with pink and white.
Green, mixed with violet and daisy yellow.
Words, singing a song, joyful as a lark, and God, in the temple of creation, hears her.
Music, soft notes rising and gently falling in quick succession. Majestic, grand.
Color, dark blue, streaked with scarlet and yellowish green.
A mixture of the most splendid colors,
blue, red, and green.
Glorified with the yellow of the dawn
and purple,
dissolving into soft cream and pale yellow.
Words. The sun rises over the mountains and shines upon the violet in the valley.
Music, a majestic bass, from which middle tones rise perceptibly, then softly descending tones.
Color, bright yellows, mixed with the color of the dawn,
dissolving into green and whitish yellow.
The aesthetics of photography and cinema has acquired a wider place in art with the use of color films. The articulation of color in a film narrative is an integral part of the filmic system. Naturalistic use of color. Dramatic use of color. Documentary use of color.
Auguste stops at the traffic light and does see the image of Valentine on the billboard. He is very much aware of her face, if not of her as a human being.
Historical use of color.
The light, which was just red and went to green, I guess, green-white. The stoplight does connect to another theme in the film Red, and that is interdiction.
Dialectic use of color. In Godard's film Two or Three Things I Know About Her, Juliet's observation points to the arbitrary and cultural nature of color and highlights that color has neither an absolute perceptual base nor an absolute meaning. Juliet says, "But what if they called blue green by mistake?" But generally, the use of color in cinema is subjective.
Vashvate, Brahman Vashvate, Vishnu Tejase,
O luminous Brahma, glowing with the energy of Vishnu, ruler of the world of a thousand rays, the creator of the universe, O Sun, you who engage us in activity, we bow to you, O Sun, receive our offerings. Hail, holy light, offspring of heaven firstborn, or of the eternal coordinal beam, may I express thee unblamed, since God is light, and never but in unapproached light dwelt from eternity, dwelt then in thee, bright effluence of bright essence increate. It's my consciousness that turns the emerald green and the ruby red.
I open my eyes to the sky and illumine the east and the west.
It's my mind that thrills to create a universal eye, brush in hand, colors in a bowl.
A noir, E blanc, E
A black, E white, I red, U green, O blue. Vowels, one day I'll tell you your latent birth.
A is black corset and it flies, boil noisy while the cruel stench fumes slow. Shadow pits, E, candor of mists and canopies, shiver of flowers, white kings, spears of the glacial snow. I, purples, blood spit out, laugh of lips so, lovely anger of penitent ecstasies. You, cycles, divine vibrations of green seas, the peace of animal pastures, peace of these. Oh, the great trumpet, strange in its stringencies, lines printed by alchemy, the angel crossed, the world crossed silences. Oh, the omega, the blue light of the eyes. With green and red, I have tried to give expression to the terrible passions of the human heart.
According to Khemendra's Samaya Matrika, there are 80 well-known types of passions, of which 8 are related to the colors of certain things. These are the colors of safla, vermilion, saffron, lac, madder, ochre, turmeric, and indigo. Nearly all significant writers and thinkers in the history of human civilization have been inspired by colors. The sensation of color, the aesthetics of color, the philosophy of color. Goethe liked green, yellow, and orange the most. Black, yellow, and red were Shakespeare's choice. Chaucer frequently referred to white, red, and green. Dante chose gold, vermilion, and red lead the most. Edgar Allan Poe was fond of yellow. Baudelaire's predilection was for black. Yellow, green, and gold are common in Gogol's writings. Herman Melville, in his Moby Dick, created a magnificent symphony of all colors. Shankaracharya, Kalidasa, Banabhatta, Ashvaghosha, Rabindranath, Abanindranath, Jibonanondo, Jasimuddin, and many other poets and authors conjure up colors.
Sito, Nilascho, Pitascho, Chaturtho, Rakto, Evacho.
I'm reading from Bharata's Natyashastra. White, blue, yellow, and red. These are the natural colors, those that should go to paint the body. The rest are subordinate colors, mixed. I'll tell you how they are to be applied.
In Hamlet, Shakespeare uses colors with dramatic effect.
There's rosemary, that's for remembrance. Pray, love, remember. And there is pansies, that's for thoughts.
A document in madness. Thoughts and remembrance fitted.
There's fennel for you, and columbines. There's rue for you. And here's some for me. We may call it herb of grace of Sundays. Oh, you must wear your rue with a difference. There's a daisy. I would give you some violets.
Associations drawn from colors form a necessary component of Indian dance, as it captures dance, theatre, and the practice of life in a colorful ceremonial. Color is intimately related to Indian classical music. The ragamala paintings define the forms of specific ragas in terms of colors. Flaubert, Mallarmé, Bresson, Herman Melville, M.F. Hussain, and several such great artists and thinkers have dreamt of an art without a subject, or one in which the subject would be nearly invisible, where white, with all its hidden possibilities, symbolizes the extreme of an artistic expression, or the inception of a new creation.
But what if they call blue green by mistake?
What if we call white black by fancy?
Chandro Tara योगिनि तमेव भान्तमनुभाति सर्वं तस्सभासा सर्वमिदं विभाति.
Neither sun nor moon nor stars shine there. Neither lightning nor fire finds there a place. With the radiance of that light alone, all things shine. That radiance illumines all this world.
Beyond the world of earthly colors, there lies yet another world of colors, the world of cosmological colors.
It seems to me that there is, in each of us,
a capacity to comprehend the impressions and emotions which have been experienced by mankind from the beginning. Each individual has a subconscious memory of the green earth, murmuring waters,
and blindness
and deafness cannot rob him of this gift from past generations. This inherited capacity is a sort of sixth sense, a soul sense, which sees, hears, feels, all in one.